we will talk about how to calculate the proximity measures for the numeric attributes data. I would recommend please to visit my previous video where I have already explained what is the proximity, how it is important in the data mining, and how to find out the proximity for the nominal data, for the binary data, different kind of binary data, and this is the fourth video on the numeric attributes. Okay, let us start. Most of time we use the three kind of methods to find out the distance between the two objects. One is the Euclidean, Manhattan, and the supremum distance. And this is formula for the Euclidean. So suppose if you have given the two set of data, X and Y, for the four objects. We have the four objects. And we have to find out what is the distance among these four objects. So if you see, we start from the Euclidean, x1 minus y1 whole square. So if you find out the distance between p1 and p2, take then this value x and y and this value x and y. Don't confuse with this one. So in this case if you see, so this 0 is equal to this value and y1 is equal to this one. Then, so this is the two value, 0 and 1, 0 and 1. Another one is the 2, 0. So this is the 2 and this is 0. Because we have only the two attributes, if I would have the 3, 4, 5, and if you are getting confused, forget about this, the x, y. Take something different name, attribute 1, attribute 2. So it will go on with these two. Because we have the only two attributes, A1 and the A2, it will not go that. So this is the formula for the Euclidean. So let us start from the Euclidean itself. And this is the distance matrix, as I have already explained in the previous video, how to get it. So what would be the distance between P1 and P1? It must be 0. As I have explained, all the diagonal data would be the 0. Now take the first distance, P1. P2, P1. So I have to find out distance P2 between P2, P1. What would be the formula here? We are working right now for the Euclidean. So this distance matrix based upon the Euclidean. So this P2, 2 minus 0. So 2 minus 0 whole square plus this data, A1 is okay. Now take the A2, 0 minus 2. So 2 square plus 2 square. It will be the under root 4 plus 4 is equal to 8. So this value will become the 2.8. So we can put the 2.8. The same way we can find out the distance between P3 and the P1. So let us start the same formula, Euclidean for the P3 and P1. This time this object and the this object. So 3 minus 0 whole square plus 1 minus 2. So what would be there? 3 minus 2, 3 square plus 1 minus 2 minus 1 square. So 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. So you will get the 10. 10 value it will come at the 3.2. So you can put the 3.2. The same way we can find out all the values here. So let me compute the value here. So it will come the 3.2, 1.4, 5.1, again P2, 0, 1.4, 1.4. We have only the 4 data. So put it with. So 0.8, 3.2, 5.1, 3.2. So this is the distance matrix using the Euclidean. So it's easy, just apply this formula, you will get it. So now I will see for the Manhattan, how the Manhattan works. In Manhattan, let me, here is this matrix. Manhattan is also so simple. So what happened here in Manhattan? The between x and y, you have to get the absolute value between x1 and y1, x2 and y2, x3 and all things. So in this case, if you do the Manhattan on that this data matrix, how will we do that? D p2 p1, what is the value for the p2 p1 for the first attribute? 2 and 0, so 2 minus 0 plus for this 0 minus 2, it become the 2, this also become 2, 4. This is the absolute, so minus and plus both become the plus, so 2 to 4. So this is the 4. If you take out the p3 p1, distance between p3 and p1, p3 p1, so p3 and p1, 3 minus 0 plus 1 minus 2, this become 3, this become 1, this is also the 4. So the same way we can complete the this distance matrix. This time this is depend upon the Manhattan. So let me complete this one. 4, it become the 6, this is the 2, this is the 4, and this is the 2. So this data, distance matrix based upon the data matrix, and we use the Manhattan here. Now the third, now the last, we see the supremum distance, how it calculate. It's also easy. Let me explain you how it works. So what we have to do, we have to take the max between the x and y. So start, okay, so for the same thing, same data, we will use the supremum distance. What we have to do here, so now the distance between p2 p1, this distance using the supreme. So what you have to do, take the max of p2 p1, p2 p1 between 0 and the 2, so 0 and 2, so 0 minus comma, because we have the one more data, 0 minus 2. So this time, don't confuse, we have, if you have taken the p2, so 2 minus 0, both the same thing, and the 0 minus 2. So max of 2 and 2, this is the 2. So let me again explain what I did. Max, so we have the two attributes, so I will take the two data. So first this one, 0 and 2, so p2 between p2 p1, so 2 minus 0, 2 minus 0, and the 0 minus 2, 0 minus 2. If you take the absolute value, 2 minus 0 become the 2, 0 minus 2 become the 2. So what is the max out of 2 and 2? This is the 2. Now check the p3 and p1, p3 and p1. So what is p3 p1? So this time we are taking this data, these two data. So here is the 3 and 0, so 3 minus 0 comma 1 minus 2, 3 minus 0 3, 1 minus 2 1. So what is the max of the between 3 and 1? 3, so put the 3. Let me complete this table. 5, 1, 3 and 2. So this is the way we calculate the distance between the numeric attributes. We have the three way. One is the Euclidean, second is the Manhattan, and third is the supremum distance. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions, please write your questions or doubt in the comment box. I will try to give the answers. Thank you very much.